Some men are designed for greatness, while others face a more tragic road ahead, filled with disappointments and failed potential. No other man has represented such a catastrophic career failure than Ryan Leaf. Once a former top 5 NFL draft pick, now is considered one of the biggest jokes the NFL has ever seen. Today, two men have decided to resurrect the career of Ryan Leaf. Wait a minute, Ryan Leaf sucks. How the hell are you gonna do that?
Through Madden.
Right, that makes sense. This is NFL Films, the Ryan Leaf story, from Super Bust to Super Bowl. I would always hear people bragging about winning a Super Bowl with their Madden franchise, and it would always end up something like this.
Well, yeah, I was playing as my Vikings, and I took DeMarcus Ware while I was on defense.
DeMarcus Ware?
Yeah, I traded for him and Calvin Johnson. Well, I might bump it up to All-Pro pretty soon.
Wait, you were playing on Pro difficulty? Or take someone who's already higher rated and turn him into a 99? What kind of accomplishment is that?
So I took Matthew Stafford, and I brought him into a 99!
Matthew Stafford? Isn't he already highly rated?
Well, yeah, but now he's unstoppable. And to get his stats up, the last game of the season I put on rookie mode.
We felt like Madden lost some of his challenge, so we decided to turn Ryan Leaf from Superbust to Superstar and turn him into the Peyton Manning he was meant to be.
These two men started their odyssey by sending the troubled quarterback to the franchise known as the St. Louis Rams, who were still the greatest show on turf. And not the team that gets beaten into the turf as they are today. To make matters less complicated for Leaf, the duo traded away supermarket sweep bag boy, Kurt Warner. And with no focus on the running game, Mike Mars' wet dream, Marshall Turf Toe Falk. For the duo of Randy Moss and Terrell Owens. I understand it seemed like madness to the virtual fans of the St. Louis Rams. But to me, I was obsessed with getting Ryan Leaf up to a 99. It was all Ryan Leaf, all the time. What station? Ryan Leaf station. What time? Ryan Leaf O'Clock. Who's singing that song with Brad Paisley? Ryan Leaf. The journey began with a week one start against Denver. Hope was high as the duo looked ready for the journey. All you really gotta do is believe. But as ready as they were, disaster struck, as it always seems to do in the case of
Ryan Leaf.
Nothing at all was going the way that this duo planned. When passes weren't being overthrown, the quarterback himself was under pressure. Passes were dropped, touchdowns allowed, the defense was playing just as rotten as its quarterback. In fact, this game had a lot in common with Joe Budden, Crooked Eye, Royce da 5'9", and Joel Ortiz. Why? Because they're both slaughterhouses. If game one was an indication of the human chess game of football, then Ryan Leaf had overthrown his rooks and was checkmated by the Denver Broncos D. And game two was much more the same. You meant to hit the guy in the stands, right? That's the only guy I saw close to that ball. Oh, I should call you Fabulous, because you really be killing him. Oh, come on. That's awful. Riley's gonna get picked. Out of pocket.
Leave me alone.
Fucking don't talk to me, all right? Knock it off.
Well, that first game was a disaster. I think we're unprepared for the task at hand, but I think tomorrow's another day. I'd like to apologize to my teammate Joe for snapping at him. Are we done here? How are we supposed to make Ryan Leaf a superstar if you suck so bad?
Thank you for pointing that out.
The best quarterback and the best running back in Madden 2003 for a couple of receivers, and we got Ryan Leaf so we can turn him into a superstar. And you're not doing it.
Yeah.
You're doing terrible. Dude, I am ashamed to call you my teammate. Dude, really? Dude, you might as well just give that to me. The team's better off me playing than you because you're just god-awful.
You could just shut up for a second. The duo's journey was turning into a real nightmare. I mean real Wrath of God stuff. 40 years of lockouts, paralyzing injuries, Stuart Scott's. Al Davis rising from his grave, Jets Super Bowls, Rex Ryan foot fetish videos, Andy Reid, Donovan McNabb, Terrell Owens living together, mass hysteria. When all hope seemed to be lost on the career of Ryan Lee, the duo refocused their efforts. They went back to fundamentals.
We're going back to work on fundamentals!
Fundamentals? In the middle of the season?
I thought the game started at 1.
It does start at 1, and you're a jackass!
The game did start at 1, and he was a jackass. When your heart's under attack, gonna give everything I have. It's my destiny. I will never say never.
I will fight till forever. Make it right. Whenever you knock me down, I will not stay on the ground. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, 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 and never say never. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do?
Momentum was back on the duo side as they reached Ryan Leaf's first playoff game.
Well, come on, you gotta get rid of the ball or else you're gonna get sacked. Surveying
the field. Wow, guys, wow. Step up to me. Me. Let's try to solve this thing. You've got something.
No.
Leaf's gonna throw a pit in. You said put on a show.
No! This is a disaster! This welcome is good, and I this is a catastrophe! To make it.
And if you're so strong, you that setback hurt the two men's confidence, now but they persevered and made it back to the big games the next year.
Ryan Leaf's virtual career ended with him winning 2 Super Bowls, appearing in multiple Pro Bowls, and holding the all-time touchdown passes record for a single season. Suck on that, Peyton Manning. What was enough done by these two men and their virtual Leaf? Has the real Leaf put so much of a negative cloud over him, or does this even register a blip in the virtual sports world's greatest accomplishments? For Dustin and Joe, I'm Sebul Fasenda, signing off.